those hands. Come on, clap it. Clap it to the glory. Clap it to the glory. I'm going home on that morning train. Somebody said the evening train might be just too late. Be careful, that might be the only one come back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. God is good. Father God, now we bless your name and we thank you, God, for all that you allowed life to be on this day, oh God. We pray right now, God, that goodness and mercy will show here tonight, God. And all of those, here, God, that you have blessed like never before, God. Oh, God, we praise your name, God. We praise your holy name, God. And everything is going to be all right, God. And everything is well, God. We come here tonight, God, to just let you know that everything is all right in your precious name, God. God, I pray healing here tonight, God. I pray consecration here tonight, God. God, I pray joy tonight in this house, God. Oh, God, bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Somebody just tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you.
Tell him sure enough thank you.
Thank you.
God is good. And all the time.
God is good.
God is sure enough good. Anybody have a blessed day today?
Amen.
And you know that you had a blessed day. You want to just tell somebody thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
That everything,
everything
is all right,
yes,
now. Hallelujah. Yes. Let's go back now again to Psalm 14 chapter that we started on the New Year's out with. I'm still got that quotation on my mind. I don't need a blessing. I need a miracle. That's my song this year. I don't need just a blessing. I need a miracle. Because I've already got the blessings. I can't hear nobody. I need a miracle. The difference, and I want us to understand that before I go any further, that the difference of a blessing is things. A miracle is God's grace and mercy. Anybody here? A miracle is God's favor. Come on now. You can pick up anything that you didn't have before and call it a blessing. But you just can't pick up a favor anywhere. It's only acknowledged to you by God. So this year, I'm looking for the miracle. Oh, Lord. Y'all can't get that. You can't see beyond that at all. Hallelujah. Let's go now, and someone will read again that 14th chapter of Psalms. Let's read those seven verses and see what the Lord has in store for the house tonight. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. No snow yet.
Amen.
Snow. I know you're sitting home in the window looking. I got a couple of text messages telling me that if it snowed, it wasn't coming. They still didn't come. Hallelujah. I can't hear nobody.
Did I give
him
that call?
Yeah, he didn't come anywhere at any rate. God's good.
All the time.
All the time. I read that 14th chapter. You go ahead and read that, Malcolm. Go ahead and start reading that for me. Yeah, go ahead and start reading that for me. See what you sound like.
The foolish said.
Now turn your mic on.
There you go. The foolish said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none who does good. The Lord looks down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there are any who understand, who seek God. They have all turned aside. They have together become corrupt. There is none who does good. No, not one. Have all the workers of iniquity no knowledge, who eat up my people as they eat up bread, mm-hmm, and do they not call on the Lord? There they are in great fear, for God is with the generation of the righteous.
Mm-hmm.
You shame the counsel of the poor, but the Lord is his refuge.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that salvation of Israel would come out of Zion. When the Lord brings back the captivity of his people, let Jacob rejoice and Israel be glad.
This is the word of the Lord. Now, so I want to continue this message entitled, How Do I Get Right with God? Everybody should, in your own heart and in your own mind, want to understand where I stand with my God. We all may answer the roll and say, I'm standing in good standing with God, but are we? What makes you feel like you're standing in good standards with God? What making you feel as though that you know God at this season in your life? Somebody else say glory anyhow.
Glory.
Go ahead and take your seats. How do I get right with God? In order to get right with God, we must understand what's wrong with the relationship. We must come out of denial and see if I'm in the right position with God. Do I have the right communication to God? Do I have the right standards of God? Why am I in the position that I am with God, or am I in position where God's located? Many times our answer is, how do I get right with God, is to get rid of sin. Well, it doesn't always have to be sin. Your thinking could bring you sin. In other words, it doesn't always have to be your bad habits. Just not being in place to bring you sin and problems with God. Amen? Because if God has already spoken to you and have given you some directions and you decided that I'm going in a different direction, then you out of order with God. If God told you to go left but I'm going right, and you do what you want to do and not what God will have you to do, you out of order with God.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we have rebelled and against God's commandments, and even like sheep that have gone astray. Every now and then your mind will go astray. Every now and then you're going to see if you got what you have or you don't have what you have. Every now and then you're going to try a test. The word in this psalmist, the 14th chapter, said, the fool has said in his heart that there is no God. They are corrupt and they have a double work. There is none who does good. Baby, that's good to know. I don't care how good you try to be, you ain't good enough in the sight of God. I don't care how good you want to be, you still ain't good enough. And the reason that statement says you're not good enough, there's only one that's really good. That's the Son, Jesus Christ. Yeah, you can't compare to him in no problem, no situation, no trial, and no area we go in. We still got to stay beneath grace and mercy. Yeah, see, there is some bad news to it also. See, the soul who sins is the one who will die. The good news is that a loving God has pursued us in order to bring us salvation. Jesus declared his purpose was to seek and to save those that are lost. Yeah. Luke 19:10 lets us know he pronounced his purpose and accomplished it when he died on the cross. Yes, that's why many people are wearing the cross like I got on tonight. They're wearing it with Jesus on the cross, but I come to let you know he's no longer on the cross. You can scratch him off. He's off the cross. Amen. Yeah. You can wear the cross, but take him off. He's no longer there. He's given up that ghost. Have mercy in here tonight. See, having a right relationship with God, being with acknowledge with sin, next come a humble confession of your sins to God. For it is with your heart that you believe and you are justified, that you know that the words of your mouth is your confession. Every time you confess how low I used to be, where you used to be. If God has looked at you and God has given you grace, your year needs to start off on God's mercy. How merciful God has been to you. Your year ought to start off with your testimony. I'm talking about God. I ain't talking about how we are treated in the streets. I'm talking about your relationship with God, how good God has been to you, and how great God has kept you, and how God has accepted you from your own trials and your own errors and your own sin. Do I have anybody here tonight? You ought to be sick and tired of being sick and tired. You really want to please God. You ought to check out your relationship of repentance and be truthful about it. If you used to be a low blow, you just used to be a low blow. But God has opened my eyes, and God has given me grace, and God has given me mercy. I made up my mind this year. You ain't bringing me back no raggedy dolls this year. If you out, you better stay out. I'm not putting up with what I put up with last year. Amen. Trying to satisfy the devil. I'm not doing it. I told God that earlier today. He said, no, it ain't your job this year. What I'm saying is, when you make up your mind what you're going to do for God's grace and mercy, stick to it.
Yes.
Let folks bring you raggedy garbage back to your steps. Back to your phone, change your numbers. If you change your life, you ought to change it anyway. Amen. Somebody ought to say glory. In other words, how do I get right with God? You get right with God when you make up your mind that for God I'm going to live and for God I'll die. You really, really make up your mind. When you out here zip, zap, here and there, no, sir. Being right with God, people of God, is a matter of your response to what God has done on your behalf.
Yes.
God has lifted up your grace.
Amen.
God has lifted up your head.
Yes.
God has placed a smile on your face.
Yes.
Well, you let no regular take it off. You stay with what God has given unto you. See, God sent the Savior. He provided the sacrifice to take away our sins. And he offered you a promise that everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. And everyone that calls on the name of the Lord, he'll give you mercy. Everyone that calls on the name of the Lord, he'll forgive you right where you are. Give you a brand new life. Give you a brand new start. Take away your old habits and take away this and take away that. But you got to understand that you got to participate. You got to know that you know that you know that God has made a change in my life. I'm not the same person I used to be. I don't talk like I used to talk. I don't go to those same places I used to go. It doesn't say that you get mixed up. It doesn't say that you become proud, but you do come with authority of God. Because if I go back there, I might get messed up. Some of us ought to be afraid to go back to some old places. Because the same offers are still there. Don't forget, if you used to like chocolate cake, you still like chocolate cake. The taste is still there. The Holy Ghost doesn't take away the taste. But it will give you a better heart and a better mind to drive through God's mercy. Do I have anybody here tonight who really, really want to get to know who the Lord is? And the Lord will make a way out of no way. But you got to want to be right with God.
Yeah.
Don't worry about what happens on the right side. Yeah. Don't worry about what happens on the left side.
Yeah.
It's our job is to stay right with God. You can only stay right with God if you stay where God is. I know you say God is all over this world, but there in some places that he is called reprobate. And when he called it reprobate, his spirit is not there. That's the word of the Lord. Don't get it twisted. Just to get an excuse to go in the house. The Lord looked down, the Bible says, from heaven upon the children of men to see if there's any who understand who seek God. In other words, he's watching you.
My God.
Talk a big picture. But can you be a better actor? I don't know about you tonight. A preacher steals on the table, how do I get right with God? Well, if you want to get right with God, and God is a very simple prayer away. Remember, sin or any other prayers would not save you. If only trusting in Christ can see you saved from sin, this prayer is simply a minute away to express God your faith in him. Thank him for providing you your salvation. God, I know that I have sinned against you. And I'm deserving of punishment. But Jesus Christ took the punishment that I deserve. So there I have faith in you. And I know that everything is going to be all right. Only if you will forgive me for my sins. Set me totally free. Let me tell you, everybody who says, I love the Lord, don't have him.
Amen.
That's only one way you can tell for sure if something has happened between you and the Lord. Only one way you can tell. You're grabbing me.
Hallelujah.
You're bringing close to you.
Hallelujah.
You'll feel it.
Hallelujah.
It begins to run like blood in your veins. You'll be very mindful of who you are from this day forward. You'll be very mindful of walking the walk and talking the talk. And God will give you something to feel. First thing you're going to say, man, is I don't know what's going on, but I don't feel like I used to feel. I feel the God spirit on the inside of me. Not that you are fearful, but you become on guard to represent. To represent the assurer that has made me whole. That has taken my sins away from me. That's now teaching me how to talk. Teaching me what to say. In a way, you're going to understand that God is your deliverer in these days of time. Do I have a prayer warrior here?
Amen.
See, words that used to bother you don't bother you no more. The pain that used to come, you think of them no more. This is David's writing here to let you know, they have all turned aside, and they have together become corrupt, there is none who does good, no, not one, in other words, none of us can be good enough, to be like Christ, none of us can look so good, to be like Christ, none of us can act so good, to be like Christ, do I have any Bible study believers, in the house tonight, in other words, you gonna have to get yourself, in your own personal circle, and get this thing right, and get that relationship relationship. Because so many of us, we're saying one thing, but we're doing something else. In other words, you're talking one talk, but it's not adding up to be 1 + 1. I've already got the 10. Only 1 + 1. Can I talk just a little bit here tonight? I didn't know if I was going to make it in here tonight. I'm trying to make sure that the vineyard was right. I don't know about you, but I want you tonight to write yourself a note and ask yourself, how do I get right with God? I don't get so holy that particular statement I'm going to confuse you. Because every now and then you ought to want to know where you're sitting. Every now and then you ought to want to know, do I have what it takes to get the attention of God? Every now and then you ought to want to understand that I'm not where I used to be. And I'm definitely not where I used to be. Because I'm waiting on the Lord. Every round gets higher and higher. Do I have any sanctified? Mom in the house tonight. Understand this. Secondly, tonight, what does it mean to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? You've been in the church all your life. You should always ask yourself that question. What does it mean to accept the Lord as my personal Savior? Well, it's like anything else. If you accept something, that means he's giving you something. You should just accept him and be who you want to be. You should just accept him and be who you used to be. You should accept him that he can use you right where you are. Give you joy that you never had. Somebody said, thank you, Lord. Have you ever accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? In other words, to properly understand this question tonight is you got to understand the term Jesus Christ, the personal, and even the Savior. You got to understand why those three benefits goes in together. And you got to not only understand, you got to ask yourself, am I ready for more? Am I ready for something that I've never been exposed to? Am I ready for more than just an organization? I'm going to tell you, this season in 2018, when God opens your window, he opens your door, he opens your heart. You have to run this time. You can't get open to sit around. You go out to run and see what kind of benefit that you can give unto holiness. You can't come in and be audacious with your wide brim hat on and look like it's Easter on Sunday morning. But you got to come in with your prayer warrior, like the gentleman that's laying here and flow Sunday. You got to come in and get with them demons and let them demons know that this is not a territory for them. We see you coming. We know who you are. We know where you sit. I don't care how many times you change seats. We still know who you are in the house of the Lord. Do I have any reverence in here? Many people will acknowledge Jesus Christ as a good man, a great teacher, even a prophet of God. And these things are definitely true of Jesus, but they never want to define them in their own work. They want to testify about how good God has been. They want to testify about how great he is. They want to testify if it had not been for the Lord on my side. Uh-huh. And the way you acting, you talking about the Lord on your side. Uh-huh. What side are you preferring to? Uh-huh. In other words, the walk and the talk is no measure up. Uh-huh. See, this season, you're going to have to measure up into the benefits of the Lord. Uh-huh. When you come in the house, you ought to be on fire. Uh-huh. However, Thomas, you got to always be the one to carry on. Uh-huh. She ought to be able to sit back and watch somebody else carry on. Uh-huh. Because every now and then, we all have some issues. Uh-huh. And we need to hear from the Lord. I know I need it. Matter of fact, I need to hear from him tonight. Uh-huh. I'm hoping church was going on and I can sit back and get me a word or two. Uh-huh. So every now and then, you ought to come in here on fire. Uh-huh. And say, the Lord is my shepherd. Uh-huh. And I shall not want. Uh-huh. There's something to it. Uh-huh. There's something in all of us that the Lord wants to use. Uh-huh. The question is, do you want the Lord to use you? If you want the Lord to use you, you got to learn to be a partaker. And do I have anybody here? Yeah, the Bible tells us that we all have sinned. And we all have committed some kind of evil acts.
Yes.
Go over to Romans 3 and 10 and 18. It'll share the word of God with you. As a result of our sin, we deserve God's anger and judgment. The only just punishment for sin committed against the eternal God, you're going to have to go through a punishment. See, I don't know about you tonight, but from Genesis to Revelation, you're going to go through it, and get the word of God, and God will, somebody say God will, God will, make sure, that he get the glory, See, I just believe, God will get the glory, out of right where you are, I just believe, that God will get the glory, out of your testimony, If your testimony isn't a lie, God will get the glory, out of your situation, If you be humble enough, and tell the Lord, Lord, meet me, right where I am, Lord, I've been down, I've been out, but I'm waiting, on your change, and he'll come, and he'll change, your circumstance, he'll change, your situation, do I have anybody, to tell your neighbor, I know the Lord, is so good, I know the Lord, is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Somebody ought to say glory, glory to his name. He'll do it, thirdly, what it means to be born again. What you mean, preacher? Be born again. I can't go back into my mama's womb. What you mean to be born again? To be born again. Somebody ought to say glory to his name. Three, John the third, first and 21st verses. Said the Lord Jesus Christ, talked to Nicodemus, and performed, that particular question, Nicodemus, had come to Jesus Christ, with some silly question, and Jesus talked, with Nicodemus, he said, I tell you the truth, no one can see, the kingdom of God. Unless he's born again. And the question was asked, can a man be born again when he's old? The great brother Nicodemus, he asked the question, surely he cannot enter a second time into his mother's womb to be born. But my friend Jesus, my daddy Jesus, he answered, said, I tell you the truth, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he's born of the water and the spirit. Flesh give birth to flesh, but the spirit give birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at anything. You gotta be, you shall be, you must be born again. And the reason you gotta be born again, so you can empty out all of that time, so you can empty out all of that evil, so you can empty out all of that blasphemy, so you can empty out all of that one sided, all that gold. Share some money, you must be, you've got to be born again. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. There's a word. There's a deep word in the belly of my Holy One. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for loving me. Thank you, God, for keeping me. All I know is the God that I serve. Promise to keep you and keep your mind. Stay on him. He'll keep you in perfect peace. If you learn how to keep your mind, stay on him. I don't know about you tonight, but I feel a rescuing of the power of holiness. I feel the glory of God throughout this building. I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Do I have anybody? Said, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. Said, no other help I know. If I withdraw myself from me, oh, where shall I go? There is a word. There is a word. There is a word. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You know that you experience God's goodness. Something happens to you.
That's it.
Yes, Lord.
You go back home only to be the same way you can't be. You want to go get somebody told and you can't do it. The Holy Ghost will change you.
Yes, Lord.
When you know it's real. You got to be real. When you know it's real. Once you ask the question, what does it mean to be born again, Brother Africa? Then there's a tough time comes. Brother Troy, you say, how can I become a Christian? See, a Christian is the walk. How can I walk like a Christian? I've been around all these fools all these years. They may want to commit me in a crazy house. My whole life has changed. That's why you got to have a testimony. And it must stay a personal testimony. Not what Queen did to you. That ain't no testimony. How Evangelist looked at you, that ain't no testimony. A testimony must be a personal concept. That's why I got to clean my yard. Amen. In your yard, you can say what you want to say and do what you want to do to it. Amen. But if you're a Christian, you can't. You got to be careful how you walk. You got to be careful how you talk. If you're a Christian, your testimony must repeat itself. Your testimony must repeat the goodness and mercy of Jesus Christ. Your testimony. Because somebody is watching you. First step to becoming a Christian is to understand what the term Christian means. Well, we must understand that it's possible to understand as a Christian, we intend not to be an insult, but we intend to be love. L-O-V-E, love. And then you become loved. But don't expect to be loved tomorrow.
My God.
Because they still know you as what and who you used to be. You ain't got to go and prove to the world that I'm changed, that I'm a Christian. Just live it. Somebody gonna want to follow you.
Amen.
Now, it may take you longer for them to follow you than you can think. Mm-hmm. Because we've had some rugged edges. Yeah. We still got folks pointing fingers. Rather than saying, come this way, they point. Go. He's trying to say, no, I'm not. No, no, don't worry about trying to explain it. Live it. Live it. And watch God around. And you know what? God will come and he'll soften those hearts for you.
Yes.
Because you declared that your rugged edges are gone. You declared that I'm a son of God. You declared that Jesus Christ is my Father. You declared that I'm through with yesterday. I'm living a new life. Not only am I living a new life, but I'm living to live again.
Yes.
Somebody here
tonight. Yes.
You can't wait to get money in your pocket to get happy.
That's it.
That ain't Christian.
That's it.
Because I'm moving. I ain't got no shout today. What are you looking at me for? What you look at me for?
Mm-hmm.
Money doesn't determine how your glory is.
Hallelujah.
Oh, so we some church folk are. Dead right. Good when somebody wants to tithe, they ain't been tithe. No, I'm carrying my tithe. I'm going all the way to the front today.
Come on, Bishop.
Showtime. Salvation is not showtime.
Nah.
Salvation is a lifestyle.
Amen.
Anybody here?
My God, my God.
No showtime. Well, how about all those other months and years we missed? Ooh, like that. Yes. I'm talking about your heart. Your money shouldn't determine how happy you are if you're saved.
Jesus.
The only thing I pray for is my bills be paid. That's all, and I make use some common sense not to make those bills no more.
Amen.
Anybody here?
Amen.
All I want to do is my bills be paid, Brother Bowtie. I don't care about all the money in the 401k. I don't care about stacking up.
My God.
There'd be no difference. You got to live that way. If you don't, you'll find yourself worshiping your money.
Yeah.
People lose their mind because somebody else stole something from them. I can't hear nobody. Lose it. Everybody come back. Somebody else took something from them. That's crazy.
My God.
Give it to God. Give it to God. Let God have it.
Amen.
Get your heart right and stay there. God give you a second chance, thank him.
Yes.
Stay there.
Yes.
Stop rambling. Mm-hmm. Stay there.
Yes.
And let the power of God prevail.
Yes.
And work for you.
Mm-hmm.
Stay there.
Stay there.
Finally tonight, and we don't get out of here. What is the prayer of salvation? Many people ask, is there a prayer that I can pray to guarantee salvation? To remember that salvation is not received by reciting a prayer. Salvation is not by certain words. Romans 10 says, I beseech you, brother, as a living sacrifice, that you're going to receive the Son Jesus Christ into your life, and he died and he arose with all power in his hands. As you believe, that spirit goes in you, and it doesn't give you turmoil, it gives you blessings and merciful and miracles. It goes into you because I received it. Romans 10 and Romans 8, read that. As a living sacrifice. Don't go through this congregation trying to live like somebody else lived. And maybe the only time they get a shout to come in here, they go home if you're healed.
That's it, Bishop.
You don't know what people are going through with.
Amen.
You don't know how much they're going through with. Some people are right on the edge of a blackout.
My God.
I have my brother's keeper. Keeper's brother am I. Doesn't mean that you're going to die because your brother's dying. And your sister's dying. Help me, somebody.
Amen.
God have what you need right now. If you ask for it.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to mean it.
Mm-hmm.
Some people come to church, they're just doing until I get my next fix.
Amen.
And the fix is not always drugs.
I got it.
Fix is not always alcohol. Somebody that will show them some attention. And they go beat themselves. I can't hear nobody. God needs some helpers with his burdens. And we're the only helpers he have. Do you think God gonna put his spirit in you for you to be self-centered? Absolutely not.
Mm-hmm.
It's not gonna happen. You think God gonna bless you to be a blessing and not bless you to be a blessing? Not gonna happen.
Mm-hmm.
If God choose you, he'll make it happen. God selects you, he will make it happen.
Yes.
Anybody here tonight?
Amen.
We must understand that we are children of God. And we're in his care. We must understand we've made up minds, it's 2018, that I can't just be existing. But I gotta have a purpose to exist. And we must understand that I want it wholeheartedly to be a child of the King. Not only be existing as a child of the King, but I want to honor my Father which is in heaven. Uh-huh. And know that everything is going to be all right. Tonight as you come, that you understand how to get right with God. I know I hear you saying that I'm already right with God. But if you're not a helper with his problems, you're not right with God. Because God didn't save you to be a self-centered savior. But he saved you that he can use you for his glory. You gotta only be used by God. In this very own season. And give God some thanksgiving. That everything is gonna be all right. Do I have any witnesses here tonight? I'm glad I got to get out of here and go home. But I hear the Lord saying, to tell them, to go ahead and drop their weapons. Go ahead and drop the field. Go ahead and drop the trials. And let go. And let God. See, when you really want to be abiding in the will of God, you got to drop all your weapons. And let God use you. You got to be willing to go further than you are and tell the Lord thank you. You can't spend any more time worried about what didn't happen. Worried about who didn't come. But all I know, God said, feel it. And I'll feel it. In other words, what are you going to do until you get your house in order? After tonight, it's no longer about you and who you think you are. I hear the voice of the Lord. He asking the question, can I really trust you right where you are? Can I really trust you to be a saint of heaven? Can I really bring you up and out and give you what you need? Well, I know tonight you won't have to drop your weapons and let the Lord heal you with his glory. Do I have anybody can testify of God's goodness and even his mercy? I know tonight this is a new year for you. Not only a new year, it ought to be a new thing. It ought to be a new blessing. It ought to be miracles you've never exposed before. You ought to say, Lord, have mercy on my whole house. Because this is my year that I come to get it right. It's no longer about me. But Lord, Lord, is about you being in my life. In other words, you got to tell the Lord to take over your life, everything about me. It belongs to you, Lord. Somebody else ought to clap those hands and tell the Lord thank you for your grace, for your mercy, for your everlasting love. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, sir. I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be alright. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Thank you, God, for all that you're allowed to occupy tonight, God, all that you're allowed to come forth tonight, God. We bless your name, God, with your power anointing, God. We thank you now, God. Thank you that there's a clear mind now, God. I know exactly what you want me to do, God. Thank you now. Thank you for this word tonight, God. Thank you for this message tonight, God. And God, I pray, God, that any sin here, God, anything, God, that's not like you, God, that you abide in right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God. And God, I pray victory here tonight, God. I pray victory, God, in this house tonight. God, somebody needs a miracle tonight, God. Oh, hallelujah, God. I pray it right now. I pray it now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Yes, God is good all the time. God is good all the time. Bring me all the tithes and offer it to the house. That there may be meat in my house, says the Lord of hosts. So open the windows of heaven and see if I won't pull you out some blessings. I won't pull you out. Blessings. More blessings. If I won't pull you out. See if I won't open up windows of heaven unto you. Give you exactly what you need. See if I won't do it. In the power of holiness. Father God, please now bless these offerings. Bless them 101,000 fold, God. Bless them. Open the windows of heaven, God.
Yes, Lord.